get to the meat and potatoes, man. So I think we started a series of events not long ago where we did a show where we were talking about this whole brouhaha, this whole fuck shit with Vlad not apologizing to the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan for misquoting him and mischaracterizing his statement while in an interview with D.L. Hughley. Now, during one of our shows, you, Godfrey, stated that Vlad said, well, he'll apologize if he can have a meeting with Farrakhan.
Well, right? This is, yeah, and I, and here's what's
and
fucked up.
And that's a lot of shit hit the fan.
Yeah, because I was thinking, because of my knowledge of the minister, from me being in, growing up in Chicago, when I started in college, and this is when I was listening to you guys, Brand Newbie, and listening to Public, all that stuff, when I was getting to that consciousness, that black power shit, I would go to the mosque to watch him speak, to watch Wali Muhammad. I would go, you know, because I want to go see what was up. So I would see him live. So I was watching the minister for a long ass time. You understand? A lot of people just started listening to him. A lot of people that come on these things, talk that shit, and just start listening to him. You know, I used to play his tapes in my college dorm. I said tapes now. I said cassettes.
Right.
That's what I used to do. You know what I mean? So knowing what I know about the minister, he would always say, if anybody wants to talk to me, we can sit down and I will meet with you. Let's sit down and have a real dialogue. That is why I brought that up. Not, I wasn't bringing up, hey, he wants to sit with a minister so he can get numbers on his. That was not my fucking purpose. And another thing is, he said, I don't need him to be on Vlad to interview. I'll talk to him on the phone one-on-one. That's what he told me.
Right, now that's something that wasn't clarified. And
in
the spirit of fairness, I'm just going to say that I think a lot of people jumped to the conclusion that Vlad was trying to get an interview and trying to monetize the situation. Nah. Where I don't think it was clear that he actually didn't say that. Like he said it could just be something on the phone or whatever the case, or they can shoot it and put it on there, whatever the case, however they want to do it. Like, but he didn't necessarily want to monetize it in that kind of sense. And I think a lot of people assumed that. So that's neither here nor there, whether he wanted to monetize it or not, da 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 da. But to be clear, in the spirit of clarity, that's not necessarily was the goal.
Listen, first of all,
what he said.
When I talked to you, I was in Minneapolis. I was in Minneapolis waiting on the shuttle. I was outside, and it was about to rain. So I'm just talking, like I'm trying to get in my points.
Right.
And they misconstrued that as in, oh, you sit up there trying to protect Vlad. Ain't nobody trying to fucking protect Vlad. I was saying this because I know of the minister's nature where he meets people. He like talks to them. Let's talk one-on-one. But then when I look back in hindsight and I'm looking and people going, yo, man, you helping him clout chase. Then I said, oh, you misconstrued what the fuck I said.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Well,
and, you know, people are going to hold on and give a reason to fucking shit on you. Like, oh, no, fuck that. Oh, wait a minute. All the shit that I've done on that channel, as far as you've been doing it before me, but as much as I have done on that channel, pushing the culture, protecting the culture, praising black women, all the shit I've done unapologetically.
Right.
And so you're going to take that piece of information and shit on everything else that I did. And that, so I'm saying, are you really a supporter of me, or are you just waiting for me to slip so you can open your fucking mouth? That's all I'm saying. But what I do love is that I do love that black folks are angry, and I like that we have that, we're protecting our people. I do love that. I like that motherfuckers are sensitive about that, which is fine. But we need to be sensitive about everything when we get disrespected in any way. If a black woman gets disrespected in public, if anybody gets disrespected, we need to be just as angry about everything, not just this shit, but everything. You know what I mean? Across the board, when we're being disrespected on any level.
So now, subsequently, after that show, people like West Coast Cam, shout out to West Coast Cam.
Cam.
People like Royce da 5'9", shout out to Royce da 5'9".
Yes.
Actually saw our video and were flabbergasted. Like, what the fuck? How dare he try to sit down with the minister? Who the fuck does he think he is? And rightly so. I mean, a lot of people, that's a great way to feel. Like, yeah. Who the fuck do you think you are? Like, why do you think you're that important? Why has your ego inflated you to the point where you feel like you're important enough to meet with, you know, one of the biggest black leaders of our time? So, you know, they both made videos where they were very critical of you and I, where think people felt like we were caping for Vlad and
buck dancing and cooning. We were buck dancing. Now we're in the same category as Terry Crews now, all of a sudden. Go ahead.
Well, anyway, I think people felt like we weren't going hard enough on him. Now, for one, I've said this before, and I'll say it again. You know, we can't always expect someone to have the same emotion that we're going to have for everything. You see what I'm saying? Like, if you're in the Nation of Islam, I get it. Like, yeah. Farrakhan is your leader. Like, you know what I mean? You're supposed to protect him at all means. Now, Farrakhan is a leader of black people in general.
Right.
And in that way, I do look up to Farrakhan. You know what I mean? Right. I got love for Farrakhan. I didn't only just listen to his tapes. I was there for many of his great. If he came to New York, I was there. And I'm talking from a youth. Like I was there when he went and spoke out at, like, what was it, this college out in Long Island? But when Jesse Jackson was running for president.
Right. Oh, okay. Damn, it's 84, 85. Oh,
exactly. And I was young at that time, but the God Barkim brought me out to the mosque in Brooklyn on Utica Avenue, and then we took a bus out to Long Island.
Yep.
Farrakhan was speaking in support of Jesse Jackson. I was there at Madison Square Garden, by myself. When he famous, and to all my brothers, you know, sister from the 5% Nation, and all, we just went crazy up in there. So I've definitely been a longtime supporter of the minister.
Yeah. I mean, and if they're coming at you like,
well, you know, I mean,
no, listen, like, I'm just saying that like I said before, I'm appreciative of the anger. At least people are up on it. We're not just because, you know, like black people, we get disrespected day in, day out, day in. We forgive everybody. We forgive this. We forgive that. I think that I hope that I said that this anger stays with everything as far as disrespect of black folk.
So Royce especially had a very lengthy,
I didn't see it.
I watched it. It was, I guess, about 45 minutes. Uh-huh. And, yo, he had a lot of good points in there that I actually agreed with.
Okay.
You know, speaking on knowing your worth and just about solidarity. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
And so, I mean, he's absolutely right about all of that. So I want to really talk about being on code, okay? Being on code. And today, you know, you and I are here to show an example of being on code with your people. Okay, now many of y'all think, oh, this motherfucker Vlad was putting money in y'all pockets and all. No, he wasn't. No, he
what? Wasn't.
Yeah, like this motherfucker, you know what I mean? I wasn't getting paid from this motherfucker. Okay, let me tell you why. My real reasoning of being on there was to have a viewpoint like mine be proliferated to the masses right now when it's needed.
Right.
And that's what was more valuable to me than anything. Fuck right. The money and all this type of shit. I'm trying to touch people. So again, right. This you can have that same you can have the same mentality of selling records out your trunk, or you could sign with a major label. You know what I mean? And it's pros and cons to both.
And don't most artists they're signed under white labels, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Right? I'm just saying, like, we're all under a regime of so-called white folks running shit. So when people tell us, oh man, look what you doing on Vlad, you coon. First of all, we ain't buck dancing, we ain't coons. So you need to look at the shit we did in the past. Mm-hmm. Don't fucking nullify the shit we've done in the past. And another thing is, all the people that are talking shit, the way they were talking, just the way they were coming at us, I thought it was unfair. That you can be mad, but don't be saying we cooning and buck dancing. I, you know, it's like the one guy that was talking shit to me not too long ago that was looking for you. And I said, my man, since we coon dancing, why don't you quit your job where you punch in and work for the white man? And why don't you quit your job since you talking that shit? I said, me and Jamar have worked for ourselves for a long time. Nobody, we don't work for anybody.
Thank you.
We're independent contractors, man. What'd you say?
No, I said, thank you, Timmy Cattell. It was a donation.
Okay, we're independent contractors. I have people, white people work for me. I'm not told what to do ever. You know, all I do is when I get a job, I contract myself, I do my job, and I get the fuck out. But half you motherfuckers that are shitting on us work for somebody white. You work for somebody white. You smile and you say niceties and you, I'll see you later, Bob. But I'm just being honest.
Well, listen, so after watching that and all of that, and I said, you know what? I'm actually in agreement with everything that was said, basically.
No doubt. No doubt. Yeah.
So, and again, we told this motherfucker to apologize.
We you told him. I mean? We told him.
I'm the one that got him to do what the fuck he did, basically, with the editing and all of that type of shit.
Yeah. But, yeah.
You know what I mean? People wanted to go further. I told him, yo, let's take it further. So now, basically, yesterday, Godfrey and I had a discussion with this man. And it was like, yo, bro, either you're going to apologize to the minister or we not fucking with you no more. Period. Like we got to stand in solidarity with our people. You know what I mean? We got to be on code the same way you was on code, Vlad, because you claim to be a Russian Jew, but you claim to be an atheist like you're not a practicing Jew. You claim that you're not a practicing Jew, but as soon as something is said about the J Mafia, you fucking got a problem. You fucking, you know, you're offended by the shit. Talking about hate speech and all of this type of shit. And it's like, yo, fuck out of here with all of that shit. So you're going to automatically be on code with your people, even though you don't even really practice that. So guess what? We're going to be on code with our people. So today, so what did he say? He said he's sticking to his guns. He's not apologizing. All right. Well, you've now lost two of your biggest draws to your channel. Now, right now, he's saying, oh, I had the biggest month ever you know, without certain people on the channel. And I was one of them. I wasn't on the channel this past month, but he's saying he had his biggest month. All right, cool. Well, we'll see now, okay? Because I know for a fact, I personally brought mad motherfuckers on there that wouldn't have interviewed with him until they seen me on there. Like, oh, shit. And was intrigued by what I was saying and all this type of shit. There's plenty of people on this motherfucker right now who is like, yo, I hated the Vlad channel. I only watched the shit because you was on there, motherfucker. Or people like Godfrey was on the motherfucker. You know what I mean? So now, since he don't want to respect the culture like we need him to respect, now Operation You're Corny as a Motherfucker If You Go Up to Vlad is in effect. Point blank. Like, and don't think that I don't have that type of power, because I do. Okay? I'm the one who single-handedly stopped motherfuckers from wearing skirts in hip-hop. Hang on. Let me give myself a round of applause for that.
You single-handedly? Right on. Did you just give yourself an applause?
You heard it? Listen, I'm going to give myself another one. I single-handedly stopped motherfuckers from, fucking with skirts and shit like that. I made them look stupid. You know what I mean? Kanye and all these type of motherfuckers. Made it look corny. So guess what? Anybody that goes up there now that's not on code after the main, two of the main motherfuckers that was on that channel said, we ain't fucking with this no more. If y'all continue to go up there, you're corny. You're corny, and we not fucking with you. Because right now, it's all about us as black people staying on code. Because everybody else stays on code.
I want to let everybody
stay on code with Asian people.
I want to let everybody know, too, people. Like, if Vlad said something about someone else that was black and prominent, it could have been Maxine Waters. It could have been anybody else, not just the minister. I would have felt the same way. So I don't want anybody to think it's just that one person. If it's anybody black that you know what I mean, if we felt you disrespected, I would feel the same exact way.
Thank you, Noah Six.
You know what I'm saying? I would feel the same exact way. So, you know, because white folks are going to always stand in solidarity. They're always going to keep their whiteness intact. And the problem with us is we don't always do that. And we need to start learning to do that and stop being so caught up in thinking, oh, man, I'm going to lose something if I don't. No, we got to stick with our guns. And it's not about being against anybody. It's about protecting our culture like every other community does. They all stand with themselves.
Noah Six just gave us a super chat. He said, although I liked Vlad, he was out of pocket. And I'm glad Lord Jamar and Godfrey stood in complete solidarity with the people, for the people, by the people.